Problem one. Find three even numbers less than 400, each of which can be expressed as a sum of consecutive positive odd numbers in at least six different ways. There's a clarification. Two expressions are considered to be different if they contain different numbers. The order of the numbers forming a sum is irrelevant.
This question asks us to find an even number that is a sum of odd numbers. And so we're going to have an even number of odd numbers to end up with an even number at the end. Let's look at this in general with a bit of algebra. So we'll start with an arbitrary odd number, 2n plus 1. And then the next odd number is 2n plus 3, and then 2n plus 5. And we'll keep on going. And you need to give this a little bit of thought, because we need to make sure that we end up with an even number of numbers here. So I'm going to finish at 2n plus 4k minus 1. And if I go all the way to 4k minus 1, what I've done is I've made sure that I've got 2k numbers listed here. And now I can simplify this a little bit. So I've got 2n appearing every time. So if I take those all out, I'll have 2n times 2k. And what I've got left is the 1 plus 3 plus 5 all the way up to 4k minus 1. You might already know something about sums of odd numbers. Sums of odd numbers starting at 1 always add up to give square numbers. But if you didn't know that already, take a look at this picture. 1, the first odd number, is a square number. And if I add on the next odd number, I get another square, 2 squared. And if I add on 5, I get 3 squared. And if I add on 7, I get 4 squared. And this diagram, with a little bit of logical argument, is enough to show that when we add up odd numbers starting at 1, we always get a square number. And you need to think carefully about exactly what square number we get. But what we have got, 2n times 2k, and this becomes 2k squared. So let's just simplify this a bit. 4nk plus 4k squared. And this is crying out to be factorized. So let's rewrite that as 4k times n plus k. And we're looking for numbers that are less than 400. Okay, so let's just take a look at what we've done so far. Started with a sum of odd numbers, and we've shown that that is equal to 4k times n plus k. And we need to find a total here that can be written in six different ways as sums of odd numbers. Well, if I change the values of k and n, I will get a different sum of odd numbers. And so I'm looking for a number here, less than 400, that I can write using different values of n and k. Let's just remove that 4 to make things simpler. So I'm looking at k times n plus k is less than 100. And I want to be able to rewrite my number as k times n plus k in lots of different ways. So I'm looking for a number less than 100 with lots of factors. What we've discovered is we are looking for numbers less than 100 that can be written as k times n plus k in six different ways, at least six different ways. And if we look at these factors here, n plus k is at least as big as k. And so when we found a pair of numbers that multiply to give our number, this one has to be the smaller of the two. And so what we need is 12 factors so that we can get our six pairs k, n plus k. In fact, we could possibly get 11 if it was a square number. So let's say we need 11 or more. And at this point in the question, you might just think to yourself, OK, let's have a think about numbers less than 100 that have lots of factors. And it's well known that 90 has lots of factors. That's One of the reasons it's used as a measure of a right angle, you can divide it by lots of different things. And so let's think about 90 and see how many factors 90 has. If we write 90 as primes, 90 is 2 times 3 squared times 5. And any factor of 90 is going to have to be made up out of these primes, 2s, 3s, and 5s. And we can have either no 2s in our factor or 1, 2. We could have no 3s, 1, 3, or 2, 3s. And we could have no 5s or 1, 5. So I've got, in terms of numbers of factors, I've got two choices here when thinking about the 2s. I've got three choices here when thinking about the 3s. And I've got two choices here when thinking about the 5s. So I end up with 12 factors. We have 12 factors of 90. And that's good. 12 factors of 90 means that we can write 90 as in six ways, as pairs. And that means that 90 will do as one of our numbers. And if you recall, we divided everything by 4. So I need to multiply that by 4. And 360 is a number that will satisfy the question. Now, this question doesn't say find every single number that meets this criteria. And it also doesn't say find 3 and show that there are only 3. So from now on, we could just do a little bit more guesswork and find a few numbers that also work. We found one, we could find another 2. But what we will do, and that would be absolutely fine for this question, but what we will do is we'll take a little bit more of a rigorous approach and we'll find all of them. But when you are answering this question, you might just find 90, find 2 more, and show that they work, and you would be done. So we're looking for numbers that are less than 100 that have at least 11 factors. Let's take our number and write it as a product of primes. So we've got some 2s, some unknown power of 3s, and so on. And let's have a think. There might be some more primes here. So let's have a think about what possible primes we could use to create our number. Let's start by thinking about 11. 11 is already quite a big prime in this context. And if we're going to stay below 100, we're going to need to multiply by smallish primes. So let's just think about 11 times 2 cubed. So 11 times 2 cubed is 88. And if we do the same analysis that we did on 90, we can see the number of factors is going to be 2 times 4, 8 factors in 88. We can't multiply 88 by anything else because it will go above 100, and 8 factors isn't enough for us. So this won't work. Okay, so we can then start to think about other numbers that we could pair up with 11. Now, I'm going to do this very informally, and remember that this isn't necessary for this question. You don't have to find all of them. Just showing you if you did want to find all of them, you would need a very rigorous approach. So you could then start to look at comparing 11 with other primes, and you soon see that it is not possible in any way to stay below 100 and get more than 11 factors. So we're going to rule 11 out. Let's have a think about the other bigger primes here. So let's look at a number containing both 5 and 7. So 5 times 7 gives us 35. If I multiply that by another prime, let's take the smallest one possible, then I get to 70. And I can't multiply that by anything else and stay below 100. And this here has 2 times 2 times 2. We've got 8 factors. So this number has 8 factors, and I can't multiply it by anything else. So you can use this argument to show that you cannot have 5 and 7 at the same time. So our number is going to be something made up out of 2s and 3s and 5s and 7s, but not 5 and 7 at the same time. And a very similar analysis will show you that you can have at most 1 5 and at most 1 7. And that's really narrowed down our possibilities. One of the options that we just found was to have numbers of the form 2 to the alpha times 3 to the beta times 7. And if you try some alphas and betas and have a play around with this, you'll see there's only one possibility, and that is 2 squared times 3 times 7, which is 84, and that has 3 times 2 times 2, that's got 12 factors. So that one's good, we're done. Another possibility was that we had numbers of the form 2 to the alpha times 3 to the beta times 5, and there are two options here. We can have 2 squared times 3 times 5, which gives us 60. Again, we've got 3 times 2 times 2. We've got 12 factors here. Or we can have 2 times 3 squared times 5, which gives us 90. And again, that also has 12 factors. That's all the possibilities when we include a 5. So remaining options are that we just have powers of 2 and powers of 3. And we can have 2 to the power of 5 times by 3. That gives us 96. And the other option is to have 2 to the power of 3 times 3 squared, which is 72, and that has 4 times 3, so it also has 12 factors. And that's it. You need a little bit more careful argument to show that those are all of them possible, but that is it. Those are all the possible numbers, smaller than 100, that have 11 or more factors, and it happens that they all have 12 factors. But if you recall, we divided by 4 at the start, and so to find the numbers that the answer to this question, we need to multiply these by 4. So we get here 336, 240, 360, 384, and 288. And if you recall, the question just asked you to find 3. So if you found 3 of those and you showed that they worked, then you were done.